Hi there guys, welcome to Guitar Interactive Magazine. My name's Tom Quayle, and today I've got a duo of guitars for you. These are both made by Cort, and they're the Sunset range, which is part of their semi-acoustic range, or hollow-bodied range. And we've got the Sunset 2, which is the one we're starting with, and there's the Sunset 1 behind me, and they're very similar body shapes, but they've got slightly different appointments. So we're gonna start with the Sunset 2. Now the Sunset 2 is a maple neck, finished in black, with a rosewood fretboard. Three per side, tuners here, and you can see the Cort logo and nice little inlay here on the body, and then Sunset 2. The actual guitar, if you look on the back of the headstock, is made in Indonesia but has some US appointments as well. Okay, so if I just turn this over for you, you probably won't be able to see this, made in Indonesia. Okay, these are just sort of generic die cast tuners that you've got here. Very nice through neck construction here. The neck is kind of it's a 12 inch radius with a nice girth to it, feels, you know, nice and solid in the hands. Doesn't get sticky at all, which is cool, because obviously some painted necks can get, if you get a little bit sweaty during a performance, they can get a little bit sticky, but this one feels pretty good. We've got, if I just show you the side of the neck, we've got white binding running down the side, which is finished really, really well. Okay, onto the front of the guitar. We've got these large vintage style frets, very nice fretwork, no sticking out edges at all. Very well, you know, good quality finishing on here, which is very nice. Really good work on the nut there as well. Really, really nice. We've had no tuning issues with this at all. Okay, so moving down, we've got these rectangular block inlays, which again are very, very nicely done. Nothing's raised or lifted on there at all. So for a kind of more slightly more budget minor guitar, very good construction. Okay, moving down onto the body, we've got this kind of standard shape that you'd expect with kind of slightly more what you might call, I'm going to say, a Brian Setzer style kind of guitar. This is definitely aimed at that kind of guitar player. With white binding, okay, piano black finish, which is really, really shiny, which is causing problems for our cameras. We've got Tone Pro bridge with a fixed tailpiece, which is good quality hardware, finished in chrome. And then we've got these TV pickups. These are TV Jones limited pickups. Now TV Jones, for those who are not sure, basically has a big association with Gretsch and Fender. It's USA made pickups, very high quality, that you would find in kind of traditional kind of Gretsch style guitars. Very good quality pickups that really will work very well for this guitar. Now the limiteds here, same pickup in the neck and the bridge position, both humbuckers, with a three-way switch. So we've got in the upward position, obviously the neck, we've got both together, and then the bridge. Very nice solid switching up here. Not my preference where the switch would go, but it is traditional for this kind of an instrument. These are kind of natural sounding, vintagey pickups. Not massively high output, but a very, very good quality sound. Really well made. Okay, then we've got tone and volume with the chicken head style knobs. Just turn the guitar over for you, really quickly show you the back of the body. Really nice neck joint. No stress cracks or anything there, looks really good. So yeah, really, really nice guitar. Just turn it back over. So let's have a quick listen to how it sounds. The other thing that you need to know is the body is mahogany with a maple top, and it's actually a chambered body, which is great for getting a slightly more acoustic sound and for lots of resonance and sustain. And it does that job very, very admirably. So it's obviously chambered in the most appropriate places to get the best tone. Okay, so I'm gonna start on the neck pickup with a clean sounds and have a listen to how the pickups sound. And they respond really nicely to dynamics. They're very kind of, the pickups are very good for kind of dynamic playing, and they respond really well to how you're actually picking. So let's have a listen to how it sounds. Okay, so if I just roll the volume down a little bit, let's have a listen to how those clean up, because we've got a little bit of overdrive running there. Okay, sticking with the neck pickup, let's have a listen, roll the volume back up and have a listen to the tone control. Let's roll it all the way off and have a listen to the range of different tones that we can get. Halfway up. And then all the way up. Okay, let's try the middle position. Tone and volume all the way up. Here we go. Okay, so very, very easy to play. Responds really nicely to how I'm playing. Very musical guitar. Okay, let's all the way down and have a listen to how it sounds. So, very musical all rounds. Pickups sound great. They feel very, very responsive. They feel very pro. And the guitar all around actually feels very professional. It's very well constructed and easy to play, which is obviously a good thing for a slightly more kind of budget-minded instrument, an Indonesian-made instrument. Okay, let's add some overdrive now and have a listen to how the pickups sound with overdrive. Here we go, volume and tone all the way up. So despite being chambered and being slightly more aimed at the hollow-bodied and semi-acoustic kind of market, this thing really does rock quite hard. It's got a real tight kind of edgy sound to it, which remains dynamic, which is really, really cool. Okay, let's have a listen to how these clean up if I just roll the volume up a little bit. Okay, same thing now, keeping the volume at full but with the middle position pickup. So have a listen to how it sounds. So definitely a very raw, kind of nasally sound coming from this guitar, and I can really hear the chambers doing their thing as well. It's even with the overdrive on, it's got this kind of nice acoustic character to it, which is great. Very good guitar for, I know I'm playing kind of rock stuff now, but very good for kind of jazz sounds as well. Okay, neck pickup, sorry, and let's have a listen with the volume control all the way up. So, great sounding guitar. I think basically the combination of the chambered body and the pickups is adding a really kind of vocal quality to it. Nice throaty kind of sound, matched with the mahogany body, that works really, really well. So, very good guitar, very well set up, very well constructed, with great tones. What more could you want, really? Obviously, with a guitar of this quality, you're really going for, do you like the looks? You know, aesthetically, is it pleasing? Cort are definitely churning out great quality instruments at the moment, so definitely check this out. Okay, so let's put this one to one side and have a look at the Sunset One, which is basically the same kind of instrument with some different appointments. So, let's have a look. Okay, so we've moved on to the Sunset One. You can see it's a pretty similar guitar. But there's some pretty big differences in terms of the appointments on the instrument. So again, let's start up at the headstock end. Again, we've got the piano black headstock here with the Cort logo. It looks pretty much exactly the same, except you've got Sunset One. Six three-a-side die-cast tuners again. If we just turn it over. Again, made in Indonesia with all these crazy numbers they have to put all over these guitars these days. Biggest difference, first of all, straight away, is that this is still maple neck with a rosewood fretboard, but we've got this kind of metallic sparkle red finish, which is really beautifully done, actually. Very, very nice finish indeed. Everything pretty similar over here, but you can see these are now Grover tuners, which is different to the other ones. These are higher quality tuners. They feel there's more mass to them, and they feel better when you're turning them. They're tighter and more responsive. So that's an upgrade straight away on here, US tuners. Okay, again, if I just turn this to the side here, we've got the white binding running down here. Everything construction-wise feels pretty similar in terms of quality to the previous guitar, even though the previous guitar is slightly more budget-minded. Again, turn back over again. Got the same quality of nut cutting here going on, really good for tuning stability. Same kind of frets, these are large vintage frets and the same inlays, so obviously they match the Sunset too. These are the block inlays, and again, very, very well done. Fretwork is fantastic, absolutely brilliant. No fret edges going over the end of the neck, which is very, very nice. Okay, moving down towards the body, we've got a through neck construction again, and the same kind of metallic finish on the body, which again is really, really well done. This time, obviously, you can see some bigger differences. The pickups have changed. These look more like what you'd expect from a traditional kind of rockabilly style guitar. I'm not pigeonholing the guitar, but obviously it looks, it's got that kind of style of look. And these again are TV Jones pickups. In this case, we've got a classic plus in the bridge and a classic in the neck position. And these really give you that kind of hollow bodied, kind of Gretsch kind of sound, basically, for want of a better term. Okay, we've got the three-way pickup selector again up here. Does exactly the same as the Sunset 2. And then we've got, it's a chambered body again, but we've got an F-hole cut into this one. Now, it's not purely aesthetic. That is going to change the resonance of the guitar and some of the frequencies a little bit. But again, it's got the chambered body. So you get that with both instruments. It's just aesthetically, the F-hole looks a little bit more pleasing to most people. And this is kind of that modern kind of, I say modern, it's more like Art Deco, actually, kind of Art Deco look going on here with the F-hole, which is really, really nice. And then obviously the biggest change, we've got the Bigsby on here. So we've got a roller bridge and a Bigsby that is a proper Bigsby, you know, real deal. It's not a fake, and feels great. Retains the tuning pretty well. Bigsby's will never be like a Floyd Rose in terms of a locked nut and really, really in tune, but it's pretty good so far, we've found. And then again, controls-wise, we've got volume and tone. Okay, I'm just going to turn the guitar over for you so you can have a look at the back. You can see the white binding there. Again, follows round the body and the neck. And then, just as with the Sunset 2, pretty simple on the back. Again, same kind of finish on the back, obviously, and it's a mahogany body with a maple top. Okay, let's turn it back over and have a listen to the pickups. So, as with the previous guitar, we've got these chicken heads, volume and tone controls. I'm going to roll them all the way up. Neck position, so this is the classic TV Jones humbucker, and we'll have a listen to how it sounds. Okay, here we go. So, nice clean tone. If we roll off the tone control a little bit, we'll get a slightly fatter, kind of warmer jazz-esque kind of tone. Tune my string up there. Okay, so great sounding neck humbucker. Again, very, very responsive, very quiet, as you can hear, obviously. Both sets of pickups in both guitars are very dynamic. You're getting proper USA-made pickups. And that's often with Indonesian-made guitars, the first thing that people upgrade is the pickups. Well, you just don't need to with these guitars. You've got great TV Jones US-made pickups in there, as you'd find on high-end kind of guitars from other manufacturers. Okay, so moving on, we'll go to the middle position, have a listen to how that sounds. So quite a kind of snappy, very rhythmic kind of percussive sound would be great for kind of funk kind of sounds, which is great. I mean, you can get that almost single coil sound of a dual humbucker guitar. That's a bonus. Okay, moving down to the bridge position. This is the classic plus now. Let's have a listen to how that sounds with the relatively clean sounds. Again, retains that kind of throaty quality, but again, very dynamic, nice and cutting, and you could really tailor and control that sound using the tone control. Okay, let's move on to some overdrive and have a listen to how the guitar sounds with overdriven sounds. So, just as with the Sunset 2, even though it's a chambered body, we get no feedback of any sort here at all, and it's a really nice, great lead sound. Very tight, very controlled. And again, I can hear the acoustic quality of the guitar coming through in that lead sound, which is great. I'm getting the kind of semi-acoustic kind of tone coming through as well. So any Larry Carlton fans out there, again, Brian Setzer fans, this guitar's going to be right up your street. Okay, let's try out the middle position, have a listen to how that sounds with a fair amount of overdrive. Here we go. Thank you. insane amount of sustain, which is great for the Bigsby, you know, really, really good tone. And again, it's got that single coil quality, so slightly more cutting, slightly more kind of trebly kind of sound, which is nice. And then moving on to the neck position, here we'll get a slightly more throaty, kind of bluesy tone. So again, rolling up the volume control. Okay, so you can really tell the quality of the pickups, sorry. They're not getting muddy at all with that much overdrive. They can really handle a great range of sounds from that mildly breaking up sound at the beginning right through to this fair old amount of gain that we've got going on here. Great guitars. So again, both guitars playability-wise, very, very good. 12-inch radius is perfect for most people's hands. The necks feel great. The construction is really good. Great pickups, that's the real key thing here to bear in mind here. These TV Jones pickups are very high end, so you know that you won't need to upgrade anything on the guitar later on. They've got good hardware built in. So when you combine the price point of having an Indonesian guitar with great construction and great hardware, what can you lose, basically? So very good instruments, definitely worth checking out. Cort, definitely a company to keep an eye on at the moment. They're doing very well indeed. Okay, so I hope you've enjoyed the reviews of these two guitars. Go and check them out as soon as you can, and I'll see you next time.